Where does Donald Trump get his information of massive voter fraud? Not from study after study, report after report, analysis after analysis that has found no evidence, but from a nonprofit group that has released no evidence. Its leading voice is the former executive director of the Mississippi Republican Party. He's now CEO of a health data company based in Texas and a conspiracy theorist. And this morning on CNN's New Day, Gregg Phillips wouldn't say what his proof actually is.
Well, you said we know that 3 million illegally voted.
Right.
You did that already.
We didn't name a soul, though. We didn't name a person.
And you still haven't.
But we will.
Do you have the proof?
Yes.
Will you provide it?
Yes.
Can I have it?
No.
Why?
We're not. We're going to release everything to the public.
When?
As soon as we get done with the checks.
President Trump apparently can't wait either. After Gregg Phillips' appearance on New Day, the president tweeted, "Look forward to seeing final results of vote stand. Gregg Phillips and crew say at least 3 million votes were illegal. We must do better." Vote stand is Gregg Phillips' mostly empty app site with no proof of anything. It's affiliated with True the Vote, a nonprofit that raised $1 million in 2014, according to its latest tax filing, paid half of that amount in salaries, including $120,000 to its director, Catherine Engelbrecht, who raises money by hiring private fundraisers and posting frightening but vague YouTube posts like this.
Is election fraud a real problem? Yes. How bad is it? Well, we have over 800 convictions listed in our online election crimes database, but that number does not scratch the surface, because for every case of fraud that's actually run through the multi-year gauntlet of litigation that's generally necessary to get a conviction, another 100 cases are never prosecuted at all.
How does she know that? Good question. Here are the facts. There is no proof of widespread voter fraud in the United States. In study after study, Republican-led, Democratic-led, independent-led, academic-led, going back years and years, no one has been able to prove there is systemic vote fraud in U.S. elections. And we've been down this road before. In 2002, Republican President George Bush, with his Republican Attorney General John Ashcroft, launched the Ballot Access and Voting Integrity Initiative to crack down on election crimes, including vote fraud. After 6 years, the total number of people convicted for voter fraud, less than 150. A Rutgers professor who analyzed data from the initiative concluded the percentage of illegal votes was statistically zero. And as for the elected secretaries of state who actually run elections in their states, not one Republican or Democrat has voiced any concern about massive voter fraud in the November 8th election, prompting the National Association of Secretaries of State to say, "We are not aware of any evidence that supports the voter fraud claims made by President Trump." Apparently, not enough evidence for the president.